Ninsabu f'Bikekara għandna magħna waħda minn ġenituri taż-żewġ ġenitur li fl-aħħar jiem għebu u nstabu wkoll matur il-jum tat-Tnejn. Vesna, your son with his friend went out on Friday. When you noticed that they didn't return home, what's your first reaction? What was your first reaction?
So, I mean, I knew he's gonna go with him, I'll be all day out probably, and he said he might return home or maybe he will stay at night with Nikki and in his flat. So, to tell you the truth, I didn't panic or call him for that matter until his girlfriend didn't call me in the evening and said that he didn't message her back, and then I start calling both of them, Nikki and my son. Nobody replied. Telephone was both of them was switched off. What I can do after I slept? I called them again and again and again until at 2:30, the police officer didn't answer on Nikki's phone, because they managed to charge his phone, and he told me about everything. And Nikki's father was already on the site with the police looking for them, and they were going to that place where they found their bags and shoes and rest of the clothes and their mobiles for that matter. And I mean, from that moment I was just kind of.
They found somebody found their bikes as well.
Yes.
From that moment, what was your first thinking?
I mean, nothing changed. I mean, I really didn't care about their bikes or anything. And I mean, that shows us only that from the place where they left the bikes to the place where they left their clothes, it was like a 1 hour, 1 hour and a half walk, which is nothing unusual for my son and for Nikki. I mean, they were been on that place so many times, so they know all that, you know, Bakriya or whatever is. So they knew about everything. I mean, they went there swimming many times, camping, hiking, whatever. So, but only thing I was thinking is that he is somewhere outside. They are outside for like 2 days, 3 days now, over 3 days and nights, alone, scared, without food, without water. Maybe cold, you know, without hope, maybe injured. That was in my head. I just was praying, I will see them alive. That's only was I was thinking.
After these 3 days of drama, Monday morning, they found them.
Yes.
What was your first reaction?
Yes, I was screaming. I have to be honest. I couldn't believe it. I got the message from a friend, and I asked him again, please repeat. And then I called him because I still couldn't believe it. He told me, and then I was like shaking. I couldn't drive to the hospital, so I asked friend to come for me. Actually, Francesca came for me, and I thank her so much. And from that moment, I was keep asking in the hospital, the police officer, whoever I met, is it true, they are alive, they are okay? And they confirmed so many times. And until that moment, when somebody gave him the phone, mobile phone in the ambulance, and he told me, hi, mom. So, yes.
Okay, your message to the Maltese people?
I think so. All of you. I mean, so many people called, people I don't know, so many people willing to help. I don't have words for that. I thank you, thank you, thank you. I mean, I appreciate, we all do. I don't know what to say. It's thank you from my heart.